Hi, my name is Averi Ruiz, and I will be teaching you how to use a slope, midpoint, and distance formulas. Let's begin with finding the slope of a line. The slope of a line M through points x1, y1, and x2, y2 can be written as M equals the change in y over the change in x, or y2 minus y1 over x2 minus x1. Which is also known as rise over run. We can remember to rise before we run by thinking of an armadillo. When an armadillo sees a car, it jumps up before running across the street. Two lines with the same slopes are parallel to one another. Perpendicular lines have slopes that are opposite reciprocals. Let's work an example. All we have to do is subtract y1 from y2 and divide by x2 minus x1. Plugging in the numbers from the given points, we get 2 minus negative 4 over negative 4 minus 1, which equals 6 over negative 5. So the slope of the line is negative 6/5. Now let's learn the midpoint formula. The midpoint formula is used to find the point that lies exactly between two points. The midpoint M of the line segment joining the points x1, y1, and x2, y2 is equal to x1 plus x2 over 2 and y1 plus y2 over 2. Here's an example. Using the points given, we get M equals 1 plus negative 3 over 2. And negative 2 plus 5 over 2. So our x-coordinate is going to be negative 2 over 2, which reduces to negative 1, and our y-coordinate is going to be 3/2. Finally, let's take a look at the distance formula. The distance formula, which is used to determine the distance d between two points x1, y1, and x2, y2, can be derived by using the Pythagorean theorem. Looking at the picture, it is clear that the distance between P and R is going to be x2 minus x1, and the distance between R and Q will be y2 minus y1. Therefore, the distance between P and Q, which is known as the hypotenuse of the triangle, is going to be equal to the square root of x2 minus x1 quantity squared plus y2 minus y1 quantity squared, which is the distance formula. Let's work this example. Lay your head on my shoulder and let it fade away. So here we have the distance formula, and here we have the points from the given problem. So we know that x1 is going to be 4, x2 is going to be negative 2, y1 is going to be 6, and y2 is going to be negative 2. So now all we have to do is plug it into the distance formula. So we get the square root of x2, which is negative 2, minus x1 squared, plus y2, which is negative 2, minus y1 squared. And now all we have to do is reduce this. So we get the square root of negative 2 minus 4, which is going to be a negative 6 squared, plus negative 2 minus 6, which is going to be a negative 8 squared. Reducing this, we get negative 6 squared, negative times negative is positive, which gives us 36, plus negative 8 squared, which gives us 64. From here, we reduce further. 36 plus 64 is going to give us 100, and the square root of 100 is 10. So the solution
now
is going
to
be
to
10 units.
Pause the video to finish the following questions. When finished, press play and check your solutions.